गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर इन ओसी एंड नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज डायरेक्टिंग। चैप्टर नंबर सिक्स। Directing is also one of the function of management. One of the function of management. Like planning, organizing, then we have done staffing. Like other functions, directing is also one of the function of management. The process of directing or this function starts after staffing process. Directing process starts after staffing process. Why directing process starts after staffing process? Because till then employees are not in the organization to whom top level management will issue instructions, orders or give guidance. That's why after staffing process, after recruitment of employees, then directing process initiate or directing process starts. Now what is directing? Directing means to issue instructions, orders or give guidance to workers. Now the process of directing does not ends only with issuing instructions or orders or giving guidance to workers. Besides issuing instructions, orders or giving guidance to workers, they are making aware them about the work to make them aware about the work. Besides making them aware about the work, making aware about the work means they are providing knowledge, they are providing proper guidance how to do the work, within what time limit work should be completed. This is called to make them aware about the work. But to issue instructions, orders or give guidance to workers or to make them aware, to make them aware about the work and motivate them to perform the work, to perform the work in the best possible manner, best possible manner for the accomplishment of objective, for the accomplishment of objective of the business unit. This is the proper definition of directing. Means directing is the process of issuing instructions, orders or giving guidance to workers, to subordinates, to make them aware about their work, to motivate them, to increase their efficiency, to increase their energy, to perform the work in the best possible manner. And why? What is the purpose? For the accomplishment of objective of the business unit. This process is called directing. And directing process can only starts after the staffing process. Once employees are recruited, then only it is possible for top level management to issue instructions, orders, guidance, to make them aware about the work, to motivate them, to increase their enthusiasm in the work, so that they can do the work in the best possible manner in order to accomplish the objective of the business unit timely, speedily, and without any obstacles, without any hindrances. This process is called directing. And one line definition for direction: to guide the workers, to guide the workers for the accomplishment of objective, for the accomplishment of objective is called directing. Is called directing. To guide the workers for the accomplishment of objective is called directing. Directing is downward process. Directing is a downward process. Why downward process? Or it flows downward from upper to bottom. For example, directing is a downward process. Reason is, here top level managements are issuing instructions, orders, or giving guidance to departmental heads at middle level management. Similarly, middle level management, departmental heads at middle level management, they are also forwarding the same instruction, orders, or guidance at their own capacity to supervisor at bottom level management. It means direction process flows from top to middle and then middle to bottom. That is called downward process. This is all about a short introduction about direction. Now, characteristics of direction or directing. What are they? जो भी आपके पास फोटो आती है उसमें लिखा हुआ है उसको आप नोट्स बना लीजिए. सेकेंड टॉपिक इज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डायरेक्टिंग. नाउ व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डायरेक्टिंग? ऑफ एनी 5 पॉइंट्स ऑफ योर ओन चॉइस यू कैन सेलेक्ट. First one is goal oriented process. Second one is continuous process. Third one is functions at every level of management. Fourth one is downward process. Fifth one is important function of management. An additional point, sixth, motivation. These are the characteristics of directing: goal-oriented process, continuous process, functions at every level of management, downward process, important function of management, and motivation. Now, explanation of all these characteristics one by one. First of all, goal-oriented process. Goal-oriented process, we have already explained this goal-oriented process in definition, in the meaning of direction or directing. How directing is a goal-oriented process? So directing process, or in directing process, superiors or officers at top level management issue instructions or orders to their subordinates to perform the work in the best possible manner. Once again, in directing process, superiors or officers, here I have not written, you can write here superior or officers at top level management are issuing instructions or orders to their subordinates to perform their work in the best possible manner. And for this purpose, they are motivating them so they are motivating them, giving them proper guidance so that objective can be achieved. It means directing process is executed in order to accomplish the objective. Directing process is executed in order to accomplish the objective. Thus, directing process is a goal-oriented process. The first part is completed, goal-oriented process. I'm trying to explain you the points in the most simplest language. In directing process, superiors, here superior I have written, superior or officers you can write, superior or officers at top level management are issuing instructions or orders to their subordinates to make them aware about the work so that they can perform their work, they can complete their work in the best possible manner. And for this purpose, beside issuing instructions or orders, they are motivating them also. They are giving them proper guidance also, so that objective of the business unit can be achieved in an easy manner. Thus, we can say directing process is executed in order to accomplish the objective easily and speedily. Thus, on this basis, we can say that directing process is a goal-oriented process. Means this functions takes the business unit towards the achievement of goal. Thus, it is a goal-oriented process. Now, second point. Point number two. Continuous process. Continuous process, we have already done explanation. We have already done in planning, in management, first chapter, then in staffing also we have done. Same explanation we have to write in continuous process. For example, in a speedy manner I am explaining that. I am not writing here. Same explanation which we have done in chapter number 1, management, then chapter number 3, planning, sorry, 2 or 3, planning, in chapter number 4, organizing, chapter number 5, staffing. Same explanation you have to write here. Continuous process, that every business units are deciding objectives, and in order to achieve those objectives, they are making plans. Once the objective are achieved, again they are making new objective for the business unit. Again they try to utilize all the resources in order to achieve those objective. Means the cycle of deciding the objective and achieving the objective goes on and on till the business exists. Till the business exists. And in order to achieve those objective, all functions of management like planning, controlling, staffing, directing are executed. For the accomplishment of objective, all managerial functions like planning, controlling, staffing, directing are executed. Thus, we can say that directing process is a continuous process because business is established for an indefinite period, for an unlimited period. Till then, business exists. We have to apply all the functions of management, including directing, for the accomplishment of objective, whatever objective we have decided, whether it is long-term objective or short-term objective, whatever objective is decided by the business unit, in order to achieve those objectives, business units requires to utilize all their resources in the best possible manner, and it becomes possible only when they apply all the functions of management, including directing, properly, effectively. Then they are able to achieve the objective. That's why on this basis we can say that directing process is a continuous process, because business is established for an indefinite period. It means all the functions of management, including directing, is also implemented for an indefinite period. The continuous process we have already done, again I had explained. Third point. Functions at every level of management. No doubt that the function of direction or directing performs at every level of management, whether it is top level management or middle level management or bottom level management. At every level of management, directing exists. Directing exists. Now, what is the process of direction? To issue instructions, orders, to provide proper guidance to the workers so that they can perform their work in the best possible manner. Why? For the achievement of objective. So, the process of directing executed or implemented or exists at every level of management. टॉप लेवल मैनेजमेंट, मिडिल लेवल मैनेजमेंट एंड बॉटम लेवल मैनेजमेंट. हाउ टॉप लेवल मैनेजमेंट विच इंक्लूड्स बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स, मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर्स, चीफ एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफिसर्स, दे आर इश्यूइंग इंस्ट्रक्शंस और ऑर्डर्स और प्रोवाइडिंग गाइडेंस टू मिडिल लेवल मैनेजमेंट. इन द सेम वे मिडिल लेवल मैनेजमेंट इज फॉरवर्डिंग द सेम इंस्ट्रक्शंस, ऑर्डर्स और गाइडेंस विच दे हैव रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम टॉप लेवल मैनेजमेंट टू बॉटम लेवल मैनेजमेंट. इट मीन्स इंस्ट्रक्शंस, ऑर्डर्स और गाइडेंस मूव्स फ्रॉम टॉप लेवल टू मिडिल लेवल एंड मिडिल लेवल टू बॉटम लेवल मैनेजमेंट. एट बॉटम लेवल मैनेजमेंट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स, सीईओ और मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर्स फॉरवर्डिंग ऑर्डर्स इंस्ट्रक्शंस टू डिपार्टमेंटल हेड्स एट मिडिल लेवल मैनेजमेंट. देन दीज डिपार्टमेंटल हेड्स आर फॉरवर्डिंग इश्यूइंग इंस्ट्रक्शंस और ऑर्डर्स टू बॉटम लेवल मैनेजमेंट. हियर एट बॉटम लेवल मैनेजमेंट सुपरवाइजर इज द हेड. सुपरवाइजर इज supervisor at bottom level management is issuing instructions, orders to jobbers. Jobbers and foremen are working under supervisor. So their supervisor is forwarding or issuing instructions, orders to jobbers or foremen. These jobbers or foremen issuing the same instruction or orders to the workers working under them. Thus we can say that the function of directing exists at every level of management. First of all, you have to explain in this way that direction, the process of direction exists at every level of management, whether it is top level management or middle level management or bottom level management. Now, how it exists? Top level management is issuing orders, instructions, providing guidance to middle level management, to departmental heads at middle level management. Then departmental heads at middle level management are issuing the same instruction, orders, guidance to supervisor at bottom level management. Supervisor is forwarding the same instruction or orders to jobbers or foremen, and ultimately jobbers and foremen are issuing same instruction or orders to the workers working under them. Thus directing process exists at every level of management. Now fourth point explanation is similar to third point. Direction is a downward process. Yes, the function of direction is a downward process. How? Once again, same explanation. Top level management is forwarding or issuing instructions, orders or giving guidance to middle level management, to departmental heads at middle level management, and these departmental heads at middle level management are forwarding or issuing instructions or orders or providing proper guidance to supervisor at bottom level management. Then supervisor are providing issuing instructions to jobbers or foremen working under them. And last, foremen and jobbers are providing the same instructions to workers working under them. In this way, the process of direction starts from or begins with the top level management and ends with workers. It flows from top level management to middle level management and then middle level management to bottom level management. Thus, we can say direction is a downward process. Fifth, direction is a function of management. We have already done that there are number of functions of management like planning, then organizing, then staffing, then directing, and last. last controlling. These are all functions of management. So direction is a function of management. All planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling are functions of management. A combination of these process, makes management effective. Or we can say efficient management is that management, is it that type of management, efficient management. Efficient management is that type of management, or management is called efficient management when they are implementing, executing all functions of management all together. Means first of all they are making plans how to do the work, when to do the work, in what manner work should be done, who is to be appointed to perform the particular work, organizing at this stage, then whole organizational structure is decided, then authority and responsibility is assigned to different officers, different departmental heads at different levels of management. After deciding about the authority and responsibility, then employees are recruited under staffing process. Once employees are recruited, then they are issuing instructions or orders or proper guidance so that work can be done in the best possible manner, in a systematic manner for the accomplishment of objective. And then after issuing instructions or orders, whether they are following the orders, whether they are following the instructions in the best possible manner or not, whether they are doing the work according to the instructions of top level management or not, that process is called controlling. Means all the functions of management, including directing, makes management effective, makes management efficient. And then only once management becomes effective, once there is efficient management by implementing all these functions, accomplishment of objective become easy. Fifth point, direction is a function of management. Thus, we can say the direction is also one of the important function of management in order to make management effective, in order to make efficient management for the accomplishment of objective in an easy manner. And last point, sixth point is additional point, motivation. Motivation means to arise, to increase the internal feeling, the internal energy of employees to do the work in the best possible manner. And motivation is possible through directing process increases the motivation. Directing process enhances the motivation or increase energy or enthusiasm among the workers. How directing process enhances the motivation? How directing process motivates the workers? By giving proper guidance, by establishing harmonious relation. By listening the problems of workers and try to solve the problems of the workers. Through this method they can motivate, because motivation is also a part of directing. Why we are issuing direction, why we are issuing orders, instruction? So that work can be done in the best possible manner, for doing the work in the best possible manner, other elements like increasing energy or enthusiasm or to provide maximum satisfaction to the workers. So such things, such factors can be provided to workers only through direction process. They try to listen to the problems of the worker, they try to solve the problems of the worker as early as possible. In this way, they can provide maximum satisfaction to the workers, they can motivate workers. As a result, worker can do the work in the best possible manner for the accomplishment of objective. In this way, characteristics of directing is completed.